if you have paper on the outside of your house, how is that going to protect you from the rain and the weather? And like, what if a bird just... So it's 1822, and you've been living on the land for a while in a lean-to, which is like a big... not big. It's like some sticks here, open, except for a sheet across the front, protecting you against the elements, and you're ready to build your first log cabin. But you don't have the time or the money for something fancy like glass windows. So you look around. Your neighbors are using paper for their windows. Will that work just as well? We might be able to imagine what it might have looked like. But in terms of how it's actually constructed, some of the records give us a few clues. So we have a couple books that give us a sense of how these windows were actually constructed. One author says, instead of glass, greased paper formed the covering to keep out wind and rain and admit the light through its semi-transparent fabric. In another book that talks about schoolhouses and says they're built on the same plan as a cabin that you might live in, they had a log cut out on one side and greased paper for a window light. And then they say, the table for the pupils who studied writing was placed under this window. So it must have let in enough light to be useful. Because if you're gonna cut out a log from a cabin that you have spent a long time making, you wouldn't just do it for no reason. You would do it because you're trying to improve your cabin. So they saw, I guess, the greased paper as an improvement from just a log, because it let in enough light to be useful. No one is gonna tell us, this is the type of paper they used for paper windows. We can figure out some things. Like, we know that in one of these, they talked about using newspapers. And we also know from one of the authors, they talked a little bit later about the paper that the general store would have used. And they said it was brown paper made of straw and woolen rags. And then as far as the grease, what actually made it transparent, it could have been packaged grease. People did buy containers of grease with other additives to keep their axles and their wagons moving. But probably they would just have had grease from their cooking. Someone does mention here something called soap grease, which I'm guessing is lard-based lye soap, maybe melted, but I don't know. It couldn't have been like a long-term solution, but maybe it was. I'm imagining like construction paper and it being kind of thick, and you might be able to see light or maybe even like shapes, but not like true, not like, they're not glass windows. No one is trying to make greased paper windows pretend like they're glass. They're paper. But how well will they actually work? I don't really have grease at my house. I don't really cook. I mean, to be honest, most of the time when I'm cooking meat, it is chicken from the freezer, so I don't really have lard lying around. I think we're gonna have to go on a field trip. Here we have the three different types of grease I was able to find at Whole Foods. We have beef, duck, and pork. I found this, which probably would be similar to soap grease. It's a lard-based lye soap. And we've also got our paper. So they only talked about two types of paper. They talked about the wrapping paper that the general store would have used. If I had to choose between this and like a tissue paper, I would rather go with this. They also specifically mentioned newspaper, like this. their newspaper would have just been black and white, you know, really dense with lots of columns of text. So it's not going to be the prettiest view. You'll just be looking at it words. I think it's time to make some grease paper windows. So, all right, we're going to set the scene. Maybe you just made dinner and now you feel like it's time to make some windows. The beef one smells like cookies to me. Doesn't smell bad. The one I'm most nervous to smell is the lard, because I just feel like it's gonna smell bad. Oh! Oh! Oh, it smells really bad. Okay, so it sort of smells like weirdly like cleaning supplies. Okay, I'm gonna stop smelling it. They would have been more likely to use the lard for their windows because in Indiana in the 1800s, like, pork, pigs were everything, so, ugh. It smells so bad! It's like the pork one. Oh no! Why did they do this? Alright, now let's open the grease soap. People use this to wash, so I don't think this one is gonna smell that bad. No, it smells. I mean, it definitely doesn't smell as good as the beef. But I don't think it smells as bad as just the plain lard. Okay, we're doing it. Gain my strength? You would need to melt this. If you used a brush, there's nothing on this. You need to melt it to make something happen. Just as like an experiment, we're gonna melt all of them and we'll see which one works the best. Let's start with the beef. So weird. I don't know if you can see this, but like, it's so weird. Okay, so the beef, if you were making a slushy, it's got sort of like, you can really dig in there and get it. It's pretty soft already. I feel like the weirdest beauty influencer. Oh, it's got the lard. So let's see, it's a lot thicker than the tallow. It's kind of like crumbly and thick. So the duck fat, I can stir it and it's already melted. So I don't actually need to heat this up. It does say it's non-deodorized. I can tell. Time to melt some lard. So let's get just a big hunk and just go and plump. Oh no, it's so gross looking. I do not like it at all. There, got that in there. Let's just get in there and just. Oh no. So gross. No. Okay, all right. We got that. The lard actually feels a lot like shortening, and I think shortening is just vegetable oil, but I always thought that shortening was trying to be like lard, so good job shortening, you did it. I feel like this is gonna take the longest to melt because it is the most solid currently, but let's see. So I'm gonna hack off a piece of it and see what happens. I think you can melt soap, like that's a thing. It's starting to melt. So we're finally ready to see what type of grease works the best with paper. And again, we're just assuming that this paper would have been similar to the general store paper. So, do. All right, let's do it. I feel like we should start with the soap grease because I don't want that to cool. So it's got like sticky consistency. That does not look like a window that you'd want to use. Okay, we're just doing it. We're painting. We're living in the moment. Oh no! Did I do it wrong? I don't think soap grease is gonna work out that well. No! No! How can you see through that? Let's try the others. Let's do the tallow next. So this is the beef tallow. It's like a really deep yellow. So let's put it right here. Okay, that's working way better. And you can see that it's starting to like really soak into the paper. This is super messy. I was wondering if it was gonna be messy. I didn't realize how drippy it would be. It's just dripping all over. I feel like I'm getting grease all over me. All right, I'm gonna stand over here. Well, this one is certainly not transparent. Do you think you have to do maybe like both sides? Hank, my dog, is loving this. So it's already starting to dry. I can see here that it is sort of soaking into the paper. Oh, it's drying so quickly. I'm gonna bring you over here so you can see what I'm talking about. This is already starting to dry. Oh no, I touched it. This one is like even drippier than the tallow. Oh, this is messy. Okay, all right, we're going. So the lard is more liquidy. I wonder if that means like you can see more out of it. The soap was just a fail.
Oh! Ah!
Who saw this and thought, yes, this would be a perfect window? So this duck is pretty milky. I don't think it's gonna matter like what type of grease I use. I feel like it's gonna matter more like the paper, but let's get the duck. This isn't as heavy as the others. This has like a grainy feel to it almost, like when I'm painting it on. Oh look, oh it's working. It's not pretty by any means, but with the light coming through, we can see some transparencies. Oh, it worked. Look, you can see. So that's what it would have looked like. It looked like the more liquid the grease is when it goes on, the better it transmits light. Like you can see, this is so cool. You can totally see through it. Oh, look at it. You can make weird shadows with it. So you're gonna see light and shadows and shapes, but you aren't gonna see colors. It worked! So now the next test is how waterproof is it? So I'll put my hand back here and I'll see if I can... I couldn't feel it! It worked! The grease is actually water repellent, so I can't feel the water. So this actually works. Let's try it again. Nothing. I can't... That's so cool. It just totally runs off. Like, if you needed to, this would not be a bad solution for your windows. Let's see how durable it is. If it's storming, a stick or a stone might hit your window. All right, we're doing it. Stick's fine. Now let's see what the stone does. Stone's fine. Acorn's fine. Even if you had a stick and you were just hitting it, it's not breaking. Now, let's try the newspaper. Beef and the lard, they've solidified pretty quickly. So I guess that means that if you were working, you'd have to work pretty quickly to make this happen. I'm gonna go try to melt this. I really should not have kept the brush in because all right, of the fat that we used up there, it looked like duck worked the best because it was the most liquid. So let's go with that for the newspaper. This is looking pretty transparent already. I am being thrown by the tech, so it's not quite the same look as just the plain paper, but we'll see about putting like more on the reverse to see if that helps. Oh no. All right, let's see if we had to use newspaper. Like, it's pretty transparent. I think I would definitely prefer the plain paper versus the text because even if you can see somewhat through it, this newspaper is gonna get in your way. All right, so now let's see about the weatherproofing. Okay. So it doesn't matter how thin the paper is. I think what matters is the fat, because I'm seeing the same thing as before. I'm putting my hand back here. I don't feel anything. There's no water coming through, and it's all because that fat is acting as this layer that's protecting me. Now let's see what happens if I throw a stick at it. Okay, I'm gonna move you so you don't get hurt. I mean, it's not going anywhere. Like, if I really tried. I mean, if you were in a really strong storm and something happened, I feel like you'd be replacing this all the time. But I imagine if it broke or it tore, it wouldn't be that hard to replace it, maybe.
It works.
I think we can call this experiment a success. So I'm not going to choose to put paper windows in my house anytime soon. But we saw that if you have the right paper and you use the right type of grease, it'll work just fine. This is so cool!